come to the end of this two-day interactive session. Before I say anything, I would like to compliment Professor B. Sita for making an excellent point. I always, whenever opportunity arises, I always kept telling my Janavignana Vedika members that we are not anti-religion. We are not anti anything. We are pro-science. That's all. We are pro-science. We explain everything by science. That itself will dispel if any wrong things are there. But saying anything anti will, as you rightly pointed out, will attract the attention. So, and not only that, in some cases, maybe by being so strongly anti, might repel that any further you are going to say, they are not going to listen because they consider you as branded differently. Let's not be anti for anything. Let us be pro science. That's I strongly agree with what she said, and that's what that has been our message for some time now. Before we talk about today's this closing function, I was reminded of yesterday morning Gopi Chandran's one of the comment. If you remember, somebody came from America to Japan, spoke for 1 hour, translation was 5 seconds. Well, you understood the context I'm referring to. We have done nothing new since yesterday we have done nothing much particularly new. Also, I know Telugu Samhita is red and chad bolbeto anchi. Oka red ache mali bolbeto anchi. Every time, essentially, we talked about same points. But one thing I learned is that everybody is thinking the same line, so there is some commonality. This is a little good to feel that that's what you are thinking is generally acceptable. Second thing I think in this meeting I learned is from the teachers. The teachers, when they express their situations and issues, are very genuine. We are talking about how things can be done on a theoretical front. As a matter of fact, if there is no teacher in the school, teachers are not able to reach the school, there is nothing in the school to show, even children are not even paying attention to come to the schools, there are massive issues. There are bigger issues than what we are considering. So we learned a great deal about realities of our education system. Despite the fact that I have toured many places, many small institutions, with Andhra Pradesh Academy of Sciences, Janavignana Vedika, or on my own interest. But still, we did not see the deeper part of it, because when you visit, you normally are presented a different picture. But I think we have learned that there are fundamental problems at the school level. Finances problem, infrastructure is the problem, and the parental pressures are the problems, which all need to be addressed. We talked about so many things here. What will happen? Since yesterday onwards, some of us spent so much time. Again, I think Gopi Chandran only mentioned that if the hall has 200 people and we spent 10 hours, 200 into 10 hours of national time is now spent. So what is the outcome of this? What are we achieving? One thing for sure is that we will draft a recommendation or resolution and pass it on to the state government and also to UGC chairman. UGC chairman, I am going to write a personal letter to him. I know him. I will write a personal letter to him about professionalizing science education. Now we talk about professional education and science as if they are totally divorced, which is not really the case. The technology emerges out of science, and science feeds on technology. If electron microscopy was not there, we would have not seen what's inside the biological cell. Electron microscopy is a technology. So technology drives science, and science drives technology. The differentiation, whatever is done, is artificial. So we would like to make science also professional, make a professional course. So, like I mentioned in the first day, that make it 4 years, we will recommend, saying that would it be possible to make a 4-year BSc program with a professionalization so that they will, when they come out, they will be treated as professionals, like BE and other people. That we will try and see whether that can be done. In addition, we'll write letters to the institutions. And some points about Inspire money coming at a later part of the period, there is not enough for the people. Enough time is not there for preparing the modules or science exhibits. That also we can try and see whether that can be taken care of. Although, you know, all of us sitting here, although I'm sitting here right now with you, my mind is still in the back of the lab, because this happens with 30th of March. By tomorrow evening, you have to spend 27 crores or 28 crores. If you don't spend by tomorrow evening, money goes back. Tomorrow is Sunday. Now, every one of us are worried about how to spend the money by a couple of hours' time. So government gives money towards the end of a financial year. This problem is always there for all of us. But we can plan. Little bit of financial discipline will make it possible, and we will request the government to see that the money is spent or sent to you little in advance so that you will get enough time for the practice. And the second thing which possibly we can do is that I was discussing with the IP Academy members. We have summer training program at CCMB. Likewise, there are three academies in India, three national academies in India. All three national academies together are running a summer training program. So anybody can write to the academies and they will select a person, and selected person will be associated with any of the fellow of the academy. They can go and spend time. Now we want to do that for Andhra Pradesh people in Andhra Pradesh. So whether Andhra Pradesh Academy, either jointly with the national academies or independently, if we can start this activity, then we will be having more nucleuses. Right now we are only few nuclei. Essentially IICT, CCMB, NGRA, University of Hyderabad, and maybe one or two in Andhra Pradesh now. Now that can be increased. That can be increased by going to many other institutions, because Andhra Pradesh Academy fellows are there in all major institutions in every city. We will try and see whether that can be done. By doing so, we'll be able to provide opportunity for a laboratory activity for more number of BSc MSc people. That we can do. But again, as I mentioned in the morning, our target audience are 9th class, 10th class, intermediate first year, intermediate second year. These are the very critical group. So we still have to plan what we can do to attract students in this area. And the only way is to make the science fun. And again, as we talked in the before lunch, extensive discussion we all had about various things that we can do. One more point I would like to bring about before I close and ask other people to take over is that Andhra Pradesh Academy of Sciences is a professional body. It's a body of scientists. We elect scientists based on their performance, and we create an assembly of people. Like the National Academy of Sciences, the Fellow of Royal Society, all these things are societies of professionals. We professionals come together to see how we can advance our careers. So we talk about each other, we talk to each other, we learn about each other, plan new research activities. It's a research activity and further in the higher level activity. So academy doesn't have any official authority or any other sort of thing. We depend on the state government for funding. Few years ago, Andhra Pradesh Academy of Sciences was a very feeble organization, which was, some of you might have seen Enadu yesterday or day before, showed the picture of academy building in what situation we were in Usman University. Thanks to the Vice Chancellor of Usman University, we are now in a better building. That building picture was an older building. So Usman University Vice Chancellor has kindly given us a new building where we moved. So this academy survives only by small grant that government of Andhra Pradesh gives. We promote science largely among ourselves, among the already highly educated, highly successful scientists to take it further. But as a side activity, because the scientists have to be made, more scientists have to come. As a side activity, we decided to take up this how to promote science, how to inculcate scientific spirit at the younger people. So that's how many activities that we are doing this part of that activity. Why I'm saying this is that many people, when they suggested academy to do many activities. Academy would not be able to do many of them that are suggested, but we can facilitate. We can facilitate large number of them. For example, if I tell something to the state government, probably they will listen a little bit more when compared to other people saying. Because as academy, if you say something, there'll be a little bit more value. Other than that, we would have very little direct effect on this. That I would like you to know that is the. And second point, or next point I want to make is that many a times while discussing, people were making points. We were trying to find fault with each other. Some say teachers are not teaching well, they are not inspiring well, and teachers say state government is not doing well and the academies are not doing well. I think we were trying to find fault with each other. It is actually true that we are all, nobody is perfect, everybody has their faults. We can sit around and keep on finding fault with each other, or stop that and see what is good in each other. Whatever we can do good to each other, just join the good part of it. If we join the good part of it, we will collectively make a better deal. I think that is very important, that let's not keep on criticizing each other. Yes, for example, INSPIRE program is there, the culture, the finance is given to some people. In some places, apparently, it is misused. Well, it will be 5% if it gets misused. What can we do? Let us worry about 95%. Because it's misused, you don't want to throw away the whole project, is it not? So I think we should be a little bit more tolerant to other people and try and see what is positive in others, so that we can make a good deal and better success into this, all these activities. I don't want to really take any longer time than this. I would now request Professor B.N. Reddy, Organizing Secretary of this conference, to make a brief remark.